This is AC, and welcome to another edition of the Sunday Show, host AC. I know this is not Monday, it's a Wednesday, and this is the last Wednesday of January. I know I was supposed to do a Monday motivation on Monday. Unfortunately, I couldn't, but I actually wrote something about life for our Monday motivation. I couldn't do a video. I was a bit down on Monday. The recent deaths, recent accidents are happening around the world. They've actually taken a toll on me somehow. I mean, the crash and the death of Kobe Bryant, his daughter, and all the other 7 members in the helicopter has actually got me thinking. Then there have been quite a few deaths as well in Cameroon, people dying in car accidents with their families or with their children. It actually got me thinking. And also I realized that about Kobe Bryant's death, there were so many controversies, so many things people said about grief, about the way people have been grieving. I know, and you know, there have been lots of shares about Kobe's death. May so rest in peace. People have been accusing others for grieving more than the bereaved. And others have actually written messages on, well, think about me when I'm alive. Don't think about me when I die. I, in particular, shared Kobe's news about his death, not because I particularly know him, not because I know him in person, or he hasn't really touched my life a lot. And to be honest with you, I didn't know much about Kobe Bryant. So when I saw so many messages passing around about him, I really had to go and search. I had to read on Google. I had to read about him. Then it touched me so much, because this is a legend. This is someone who is so rich. This is someone who is so popular. He has lots of followers. This is someone who is a good dad. Obviously, he's a good husband. And he didn't die alone. He died with his daughter and other people in the crash. And it got me really thinking. Recently, so many people have been dying, especially people in their 40s, both men and women, and I'm wondering what's happening to each individual that's dying. I'm wondering what's happening to us that who are still alive. Are we ready for our death? Are we ready for tomorrow? And I've come to realize that life is so short, and life should not really be taken for granted, because in the blink of an eye, that life can be taken away from you. So when you get into your car today, you get into a helicopter or a plane to travel, when you come back home safe, it's by the grace of God. It's not by your grace, it's by the grace of God. And so we have to be grateful for that life that God gives us, because I know life is a precious gift given to us by God. And the gift that we can give back to God is how we make use of this life that he has given us. And another thing which I would like to touch as well is people have been accusing each other for grieving more than the bereaved. For your information, grief, anyone can grieve. You can grieve anyone. You can grieve anything. Grieving actually is not just about death. You can grieve a divorce. You can grieve a disability. You can grieve a lifelong illness in the family. You can grieve the loss of a job. You can grieve the loss of a friendship. There are so many ways to grieve. And if I am grieving the death of Kobe today, it's not because I personally know him. It's not because he is my family member. It's not because he's someone so special to me. Why I grieve personally is because his death has touched my life, and I know that death is inevitable. And each and every one of us will die tomorrow, and each of our family members will one day die. And I will not expect someone to ask another person, why are you grieving this person who is not related to you? You don't only grieve your relatives. The reason I am grieving Kobe's death especially when I read about him, his wife, his family, is because there are a few things about them which have touched my life as well. Yes, you also grieve somebody. Maybe that person's story, it's relating or has something in common with you that has happened in the past that caused you to grieve. So when I read about Kobe and his wife, I think her name is Vanessa, I discovered that way back in 2005, his wife had a miscarriage. And so many years later, they've lost a 13-year-old child. Yes, I relate because way back in 2005, I had a miscarriage. Back in 2017, I lost a child. So all those memories, their story brought back my own memories. Then I realized that you cannot only grieve somebody whom you've known, somebody whom you are related to. You can grieve anybody depending on how that person touched you, depending on how that person's story has touched you. Then, before I end this video today, I would just like to say something about grief. Maybe each and every one of us will be able to learn from this. I will have to read it out. I would like to say that there is no proper way to grieve. You can choose to handle your grief in a way that feels right to you. Yeah, there's no proper way to grieve. You can choose to handle your grief in a way that feels right to you. A broken heart is a broken heart, and you just have to take it as it comes. You are on a difficult path, so don't stop. Don't rush. Don't get past it. Take it one step at a time. You cannot go around your grief. You cannot go through your grief. You can move forward with your grief. And don't judge someone for grieving. That's me for today. It's AC, your host at The Sunday Show. Love you all and see you next month, February. Stay blessed. Love you always. Bye.